This is Bill Pence, and I'm here on the Delta at the 1985 Delta Bridge Tournament. I'm going to start off by interviewing last year's winner of the tournament, Linda Pence. Tell me, Linda, how do you think your chances stack up for a repeat win this year?
I think my chances are excellent for a repeat win. I'm confident. I feel strong.
Have you been training hard for this match?
Only on Saturday evenings.
And who do you feel looks to be, at this stage, your toughest competition?
Well, it's really hard for me to talk about my competition. I'd rather not say. I don't want anyone to get an outside advantage.
There you have it. Last year's champion going for second straight. And actually, I think you've won this in the past, haven't you? Wouldn't this be three?
Yes, I have won this in 81.
There it is, going for an unprecedented third win and two in a row. Linda Pence. It was Labor Day in 1983, Ted, when you racked up 16,730 points to beat Richard by 200. Do you think you can do it again?
Well, I'd really like to try, although that fades from memory at this point in time. I think that's a somewhat unofficial tournament, and we really didn't award prizes. That was a non-money event. But yeah, I think that the Caltech dynasty will continue on here, and you know, the supremacy of that team will overcome.
But what do you think it's going to take to nail Linda again? Because she did 18,000 points last year, and she looks like the clear pre-tournament favorite.
Well, we know that 18,000 points will win almost any year. On the other hand, if you look back here, if you get over 15,000 points, you're going to be in real good shape. So I think the importance in this tournament is just consistent. If you get a string of bad cards, don't get carried away. Just keep playing your game, and that will serve you well.
Now, do you have any... Ted, do you have a specific strategy this year?
Well, yeah, I haven't been playing that much bridge lately, so I'm going to kind of cool it, try and play consistent, accurate bridge. Minimum error rate, nothing too flashy.
Thank you, Ted. You've heard from the pre-tournament favorites. We'll have some interviews shortly with some folks who have threatened in the past, but never yet won the biggie. Nancy is regarded by some as the finest technical bidder here at the tournament, and yet she's failed to win the top prize in the past. Nancy, why do you think you've been unable to score a major victory here at this tournament?
No comment.
No comment from someone who is regarded as a potential winner this year. Have you been looking forward to this tournament?
No comment.
No comment. Perhaps Nancy has a secret strategy in mind. Would you care to comment on that?
No comment.
What's for lunch today?
I don't know.
From the Delta Bridge Tournament, an interesting and possibly challenging turn of events. Well, Ginger, always a bridesmaid, never a bride. No. How do you see your chances this year?
My chances this year, I'm in. This is my year, Bill. Having come in, I've been the head statistician for 9 years now. I've worked these figures, and I know that it's my turn. I know this is my year. What do you think, Bill?
That's a very, very confident attitude. Have you been practicing, or do you have any special strategies lined up for this year?
No, just slow skill. I think I'm there.
From the kitchen at the Delta, we've got a green chili casserole this morning. Calls for lots of eggs and cheese for you cholesterol lovers. And Sue's on for lunch and dinner.
Well, and you don't want Sue for lunch.
Oh, okay. Well, and Ginger's on after the lunch. I I think this will be a good breakfast. I mean, hopefully you'll stick around and enjoy it. Signing off. Good morning.
Okay, this is the Emery's boat, and we bought it in 1972. It's a glass par with 205 horsepower. We just got the interior done last year, and we only use it like 1 or 2 weeks a year in Lake Tahoe. And it runs good, still runs good after 14 years.
Okay, we're on our way up to Orwoods to get some gas. We only have a quarter of a tank. And we think we need that. We'll be going out through the cut here into the fast zone, hang a left, and take off down the channel. We have young Bill Pence in the water. We're getting ready to take off. This is an early demonstration of his skills that he learned at Rollins College in Florida.
So I just followed directly behind that boat.
Yeah. Okay, and he just made a beautiful left-handed cut. That mountain in the background is Mount Diablo, and as you can see, he's a little... Okay, here we are on Middle River. Just made one of his left-hand turns, getting into the rhythm. Nice right-handed cut. And there he goes. Okay, what? Too bad there, though. The rope hit the water. I think we've got him a little tired from working out here. Nice cut. There he goes, spun out.
Nice one.
And here he goes again. Nice right-handed turn. Let's check this left-handed turn. Oh, a little slack rope there. Stay tuned, ladies and gentlemen. We're now on Dead End Slough. Young Bill Pence just made a fantastic right-hand turn. There's a good left-hand one. Hopefully he won't fall, or we'll be picking him out of the rocks. Shore fishermen are being terrorized. Oh, nice recovery. Nice recovery. Man, he's gone.
Well,
let's see if he adjusts his suit. No, he pulls out straight ahead, please. Around to the left, and he makes a turn. Nice turn. He's out to the right. Okay, need to warm him up. We're coming to the dredge. We'll have to stop here in a few minutes. He's got time for just a couple, three turns. Nice, nice. And here we go. Oh, there is a nice left-handed turn, ladies and gentlemen. Makes another one. Let's see this. Oh, and he's down. Just in time.
We have
Alan Emery at the end of the rope here. We've just pulled out of the Dead End Slough dredge. Makes a nice right-handed turn. Needs to work a little on his hand technique. Take the channel to the left, Billy. Good. Oh, and he makes a deep left-handed cut. Excellent, excellent. Passing underneath the Middle River Bascule Bridge. Okay, here we go. We're heading down Slough beside the Santa Fe Railroad tracks. We have Alan Emery out there. Just did a chin-up right-hand turn. Nice. Out in the tules, made a nice left-hand turn. Good leg action through the wake, if you'll notice that. Oh, and he almost dug in too deep. Nice recovery. Nice recovery. A little too much slack on that last right-handed turn. But here he goes. Digs nice and deep on these left-handed turns, gentlemen. And a nice cut. Here he goes. Here he goes. If he falls, he'll be picking the moss out of his suit. But nice turn. Andy
Jenkins up on the ski.
Resumes the relative.
Somewhere along Middle River, I think. I think we should be going a little bit faster. It looks like the boat can hardly pull, Ted. There's a pretty good cut. your stuff. It's called the plow, the equivalent of the snow plow on water skis. I think maybe we should be going a little bit faster.
Why don't you go a little faster?
Jenkins doesn't seem very energetic this morning. There he goes, moving a little bit now.
Well, here it is, the second day, and we're talking to Richard Bonnet. Richard was the pre-tournament favorite, and at the end of the first round, he's in second place, narrowly out of first. Richard, do you think you're well-positioned for rounds two and three of this tournament?
Well, Bill, I really do. You know, I think that I've been second for so many years in a row that this has got to be my year. I think this has just got to be it. And I'm only 200 points behind you, Bill, and that's really not much to make up.
Would you rather be playing from the second place position for this round today than the lead position?
Oh, certainly. Certainly. When you're in the second position, then you're in a position to try harder. When you're first, everyone's trying to get you. No question today, Bill, your partners will fall apart on you as we go through the day.
Is today the critical round, or do you think the third round is more important?
No, actually, the third round and the last hand of the third round. I've lost the last 2 years on the last hand of the last round. So it's all in the, we're all in the running until the last day. But I'm in good shape, no problem.
Is your strategy today to lay back and let the others make mistakes, or is today the day to really push?
No, I think I should be aggressive today. I think I'll be bidding very strongly, and I won't be missing those hands that I've missed before. I missed too many.
You've got about an 800-point lead over the third-place player. Do you see anybody else challenging?
Oh, I think 800 points can be used up.
We have Steve Cooper playing a doubled small slam in four spades. The bidding, six spades. The bidding went as follows. This was a two-club opener. A 3-no response to four hearts, then four spades, and Steve asked for aces, and Jenkins took it to six spades. It's a dicey contract, and nobody knows exactly how it will come out. Ginger ended up doubling before we got all done, so there's a lot of points on the line here, regardless of how it comes out.
Well, Steve, you're about 2,000 points off the pace in the middle of the second round. Do you think there's enough time left to mount a move?
I think there's plenty of time. I prefer to be water skiing, but if the bridge gods are grateful to me, I think I can come back.
What kind of cards do you think it's going to take to pull in the lead from this point on?
22 points per hand average, I think, ought to be sufficient.
Do you think there's a better strategy, perhaps, than going for top overall, considering the change they made in the slam pot rules? Isn't it better, perhaps, to be a little more aggressive at this stage?
Yes, I've been thinking about changing my strategy, and I think this next round you'll see me making a move towards trying to go after that slam pot.
Well, good luck to you, Steve, and we'll be seeing how that strategy works. So this has been a particularly difficult tournament for you. I know you've been playing with less strength than you'd like to have at this point. Do you think that perhaps the weather or the course conditions have had something to do with your standings at this time?
I think it's mostly the bridge gods. This is Sunday. I've given my, I've done my little prayer and lit the incense over there. So we're going to try hard today. We have, I'm going to get cards.
So with at this point in the standing, with a 2,700-point shortfall, what kind of cards do you think it's going to take to pull you into a medal position?
All pictures.
All pictures.
Mm-hmm.
Which particular matchups do you think will be critical in terms of which partners will you have to play well with in order to gain on the leaders?
Well, Nancy and I, if we could do real well, we could do a lot of gaining, and hopefully Steve and I can do something. We certainly know one another well after all these years, but that doesn't mean the cards will cooperate.
What you're saying, if the number 7 and number 8 players team up with some very heavy points, there's a chance you could upset the leaders and possibly move into a medal position?
Closer. I don't know about first, second, or third, but we could at least come in the middle.
Well, there you have it. With seven rounds to go, there is still a possibility for an upset.
Good. These are the results of the 1985 Bridge Tournament. We're starting with the third place winner overall. That's Richard Bonnet. His cash award is $24. That's calculated on 2 days at second for nine apiece, and then six for being third overall.
Yay, Richard!
Richard, here is your $24. Thank you very much for joining us. May I shake your hand?
Sure.
Oh, okay. The second place winner overall is Ginger Jenkins. Her cash award is $32. That's calculated on $14 for second place overall and $18 for winning first place in round number two. Would you, there's your money. Would you care to give us a reaction to, you were in first place at the beginning of the last round, and you know, this must be a difficult defeat for you. How do you really feel about that?
Well, it really, let me tell you, no bitter tears or anything like this. I mean, it really, when you're running all ahead the whole way, well, I just want to say.
Well, that's how it is here at Discovery Bay, ladies and gentlemen. Let me move on. I would like to announce our first place winner. This is the first time that anybody has won the games four times. Bill Pence's cash award is $66. That's calculated on two first place rounds and first overall at $30. So he's at $66. Here's your $66, Mr. Pence. I'd like to congratulate you on
your
fine achievement. Before I get your reaction, I would like to add that Bill was able to earn this award with the lowest overall winning score that we have ever had. So how do you really feel about this half-assed victory?
Well, I'll tell you, Ted, the competition was extremely tough this year, and it was probably the finest field that's ever all competed up here at this tournament. But conditions were just excellent. My crew was excellent. The track was excellent. And we were just goddamn lucky to eke out that kind of victory. Thank you, thank you.
Well, that's how it was, ladies and gentlemen. And remember, you were here.
Steve Cooper was fourth place, and we have no mic.
Right here.
Oh, Steve.
I thought you were out of film.
He's out of film. Steve Cooper was in fourth place with no cash award. Linda Pence had $9 for being in fifth place. Ted got $1 for a last place finish. And Nancy Bonnet, unfortunately, two last place daily finishes. I'm going to kind of cool it because I haven't been playing as much bridge as I normally do, and I'm just going to have to be real careful here. So I might be playing a little bit slower than usual. God forbid.